Welcome all. From this lecture onwards, we will start with the basics of arrays, and this is part 1 of basics of arrays. So let's get started. This is the outline of this lecture. First, I will give you the definition of array, what array is all about. Then I will make sure that you will understand the definition of array. And then finally, I will introduce you to one-dimensional array. So let's get started with the definition of array. An array is a data structure containing a number of data values, all of which are of same type. In order to understand this definition, I will divide this definition into three parts. First, I will tell you that what a data structure is all about. What is data structure? Data structure is a format for organizing and storing data. It is a format in which you can organize the data. Also, you can store the data. Also, each data structure is designed to organize data to suit a specific purpose. For example, an array is a data structure which you can visualize as follows. This is the way you can visualize an array. It's a large chunk of memory divided into smaller blocks of memory, and each block is capable of storing a data value of some type. This is the way you can visualize an array. It's a data structure because here you are storing the data, as well as all the data is organized in a sequential manner, right? That is why an array is a data structure. In each block, you can store some data of some type, and all of them are organized in a sequential manner. So we can understand that an array is simply a data structure, right? So the first part of this definition is very clear, that an array is a data structure. Let's come to the next part. It contains a number of data values. What does it really mean? This array consists of 10 data values. You can see this array consists of 10 data values, all of which are integers, and each value is stored in a separate block of memory, right? So, we can say that an array contains a number of data values. This array contains 10 data values. Similarly, this array contains 5 data values, and again, all of which are of integer type. So, the second part of the definition is also clear, that an array consists of number of data values, right? Let's come to the third part of this definition, all of which are of same type. Let's try to understand this third part as well. Data type of array elements. This array consists of all integer values, right? And this array consists of all characters. But what about this array? This array consists of characters, integers, floats, but the definition says that all elements must be of same type. So I can say that this is correct, but this is not correct, because the type of all these elements are not same. That is why it is not a correct array. Either an array consists of all integers, either it consists of all characters, all floats, all doubles, or whatever you can imagine, but it is not possible that an array consists of multiple types of elements. Finally, we can say that the definition is clear. An array is a data structure containing a number of data values, all of which are of same type. First of all, it is a data structure, that is a format for organizing and storing data. Also, it consists of number of data values, and all of them must be of same type. It is not the case that one array consists of multiple types of data. It should always consist of data of same type. Now, I will introduce you to one-dimensional array. The simplest form of array one can imagine is one-dimensional array. Let's see how a one-dimensional array looks like. This is how a one-dimensional array looks like. This is already what we have seen, right? So the array that we have already seen is nothing but a one-dimensional array. It is a large chunk of memory, a single row, divided into number of blocks, and each block is capable of storing some data value, right? And all of them must be of same type. You can also imagine a block of memory as a variable and an array as a collection of variables. Now it's up to you how many variables you require in your array and what is going to be the type of the values which you will store in your array. Okay friends, this is it for now. Thank you for watching this presentation.